Hello everyone, my name is Kaushiki Sondi and thank you Teachers Tribe International Community for inviting me today for the webinar that is Soft Skills are the Hard Skills of Today. And my name is Kaushiki Sondi. I'm working as a principal Holy Public Girls School, Agra, and also as a board of advisory with the three universities that are Bharat University, Sri Venkateshwar University, Pondicherry, and International Internship University as our education ambassador. And also I'm working at the board of advisory with National Council News and Broadcasting and working as a vice president all in the Council for Human Rights, Liberties and Social Justice and many more organizations. Working in the educational field, I have seen that soft skills are very much important for today's life as compared to the hard skills. And students require their enrollment in the soft skills to be a greater leader of tomorrow. So working on the same concept today, I will be sharing a presentation here. And thank you, ma'am, for inviting me for the webinar. So let's start without any delay. So let's start with a presentation, a short presentation that will give you a brief about what actually soft skills are and how we can make them a part of our daily life, and how students can get more exposure about them so they can use them for their coming lives and for the betterment of the society. So yes, I think you are able to see my screen now. So working ahead, first of all, I'm sorry. When we talk about what is soft skill, so we are talking about many things, which one of them is personality. So when we talk about personality, personality means spiritual, emotional, mental, and social and physical development of a person all together to make them enroll in day-to-day life. The combination of all these together make a person a great personality. How flexible you are, what is your sense of humor, how patient you are, how adaptable you are, how curious you are, all these factors attached make you a great person, a great personality, and that calls makes you to have the soft skills enrollment in your life and to be a great leader of tomorrow. Now, how, when we talk about personality development, so what personality development means? Personality development is actually the development from the organized pattern of attitudes and behavior which makes an individual distinctive. There are some characteristics of personality development. They may be dressing up well, being optimistic, being a good learner, being patient listener, and dressing up in a good attire, watching your body language, your gestures, and being confident. Now, there are some different kind of personality traits which everyone have. When we talk about personality traits, the person can be extrovert, the person can be sensor, the person can be thinker, the person can be a judger, introvert, feeler, or possessive. So there are different kind of personalities around us and we have to deal with them. And that is what a soft skills is about. How you are dealing with the person around you, how you are dealing with the external environment around you. So when you say the external environment is full of these kind of personalities, and when we know how to deal with these kind of personalities, this is actually our personality development. This is actually what soft skills are about. Moving ahead, there are some personality development tips. There are some personality development things which we can do into our day-to-day life to make us a better person. They can be improving your body language, reading habits, mastering your soft skills, socializing, improving your speaking skills, self-evaluation. When we say self-evaluation, it means SWOT analysis, being yourself, a good listener, being confident, strive to be independent, work on your attire, try to be dynamic, energetic, healthy lifestyles, and develop sense of humor. Now, when you say self-evaluation, it means SWOT analysis. And what is SWOT analysis? SWOT analysis stands for strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. SWOT analysis for a student implies a part that are good at to be factors that need to be improvement. Through SWOT analysis, a student can analyze what opportunities lies ahead. Now, SWOT analysis can be internal, can be external, can be positive, can be negative. Strengths means what professional qualities do I have? Thinking about that. Weaknesses mean what I am bad in. I need to work on it. Opportunities means what trends do I see in my professional area. Threats means what obstacles do I face, and so on. So working on the SWOT analysis, a person can have a great personality, and a great personality is the first and foremost thing to work on your soft skills. Now working ahead, like this is some kind of activity which you can also take in consideration while going to a school. If you are a principal or you are working in educational field with the students, you can take this activity with the students and just see that they make a change to their attitude, to their personality, and to the soft skills. So when we have quoted here, given a number to all the alphabets here, and when we do a total, when we do a total of a skill and knowledge and hard work and attitude, all are different. But the total of attitude what we get is 100%. So this is a result we get when we ultimately do it with students in the school. And this is what we see. This is something which we observe, that attitude is something which is also always a part of a person, a personality, which makes him a better. Now, how to have a great attitude? Because to have a great attitude, to have a great personality, some factors are required, and they are like being polite, being patient, praising yourself, willingness to learn, urge for the knowledge, hardworking nature and pervasive, good reading habits, set of realistic goals, thinking logically, do not react, be assertive, be confident, do not rely on good luck, work hard, trust your strengths, SWOT analysis, should possess a hobby, you should have a hobby, and respecting towards elder and giving to the nature back. Now, what is soft skills? Now, coming to the topic of today, what is soft skills? Soft skills are the character traits and interpersonal skills that make a person's relationship with other people. In the workplace, soft skills are considered to be more complement to hard skills, which refers to person knowledge and occupational skills. When we say what is EQ and IQ, I think you must be hearing these words from long time, because these are some common terms. IQ is intelligence quotient and EQ is emotional quotient. I give you a small example. As a child is born, all the sensory things are being checked. When he gradually grows up, we work on more of his intellectual part, on the brainstorming sessions, and we forgot about developing the sensory part. So hard skills are actually the development of the sensory part, how you are talking to the people, how the environment is giving you back, how people are reacting to your things. All these factors are the soft skills parts. And now coming back to the balance of EQ and IQ, it means the balance between the hard skills and the soft skills. So we need to tell our students, to the kids, to the people around, that both the balance are required. You can't work on the hard skills and just ignore the soft skills, or you can't work on the soft skill and ignore the hard skills. Both require a balance, a quality balance. Now, there are some top six soft skills, which over the period of time, I think these are most important thing which we need to focus, which we need to have exposure about, and these will make our personality or attitude a great change, a great achievement, a great approachable person we would be. So that these things should be developed over a period of time. They are communication, your attitude, teamwork, networking, problem solving, critical thinking, and professionalism. Now, see, as I told you that hard skills and soft skills both require our balance. So now working upon the technical skills and people skills, the students should know that they both require our balance between them. Now, how you're working on your STEM education, how good you are mathematically, how good your data technical soft skills are, how subject matter expertise you carry, along with the collaboration process, along with the curiosity, along with the communication, along with the creativity, all these factors count to make you a great person. So in schools, you can carry out the storytelling things where the students can, you know, have an imagination session where they can just have an imagination session and just make some story out of the random things, and they can help them to have a great communication skill, even though with along with the great imagination and curiosity around the things they are framing, along the things they are facing, and they can have a great change. Now, other activity you can have, like if I ask you, the people around, that if you can just let me have your pen for some time, and without any communication, without any words, I just want to deliver you this message. So what actions, what gesture I would be providing you to have my message into a very perfect manner. So these kind of things you can have, these kind of activity you can have, where you can make students and the people know that your gestures work more than the communication, and you can make them work on their gesture, control their gestures, control their behavior skills, control their sitting skills, and they all matters a lot when you're going for interview or for any such kind of thing. Moving ahead, as we know that 55% of body movements are important, 7% of words are important, and 38% of your voice pitch are important. So we need to work on our body movements, our face, arms, how we are behaving, how we are reacting, how we are making people feel around us. All these factors are very much important. Communication enables leaders to share what they have and what they expect from others. So it is effective communication which makes leaders to lead successfully. The sender is sending a message to the receiver without feedback, and there should be no noise between. The encoding and decoding should be very much clear. Communication skills for the job interview. When you are going for the job interview, these are some basic tips which you need to work on. You should keep your phone aside. You should not keep it, you know, Googling your phone and you are looking down. The person around you feel ignorant. So you should be very much aware about it. Nowadays, we are doing that. The person next to us is feeling ignorant and we are much engaged with the phone. So we need to, when we are going for such kind of thing, such kind of interview, job interview, we need to be very much aware about this. So leadership needs three types of focuses, and these focuses are inner focus, outer focus, and other focus. When we say inner focus means self-awareness, social emotional well-being. Outer focus means social awareness, community support. Other focuses means external environment. Inner focus means how you are behaving with the people around, how you are delivering your speech to them. Outer focus means how people are reacting to the things you are delivering to them, how they are approaching you. And the other focus means the things around you which you are unaware about. Are you aware about them? So you need to work on these three kinds of focus. See, there is a difference between being a leader and being a manager. A leader is a personal power, whereas manager is a positional power. Leader means being influencing, whereas manager means being forceful. So you need to choose, you need to be a leader or you need to be a manager. Moving ahead, leadership skills from great personalities. So leadership for the great personality are self-awareness, being proactive, reacting before the things can, you know, have an influence on you, time management, responsible decision, trust your ability, communication skills, keep learning, SWOT analysis, critical thinking, personality development, and reading and learning. These things add to your personality. Now, some people ask me, some students ask me that, ma'am, are leaders born? So yes, leaders are born, but still there are some situations and there are some kind of things where you can be a leader. So leaders are not actually born. It's all about the personality development and the attitude you're carrying, and the combination of both of them make you a leader. So now focus on soft skills of any employer in any field. You need to have a positive attitude, leadership quality, interpersonal skills, strong work ethics to collaborate, productivity. We need to work on our sensory system to be more relative and positive. We giving importance to only intellectual knowledge, books, not soft skills. So how to speak, how to be skillful, disagree, job without conflict, integrity, active listening, empathy, problem solving, answering interview questioning, and stage representation, leadership qualities. All these factors adds to your personality, adds to the soft skills. The future workplace will rally on soft skills only. A study by Deloitte assess economics precede that soft skills occupation will account for 2/3 of the jobs by 2030. So strengthening your soft skills is something which is required. So thank you for the session, and thank you. And I just want to end this session with a great thought, that is, excellence is not a skill, it is an attitude. And stopping here my sharing, and now with some information about what's soft skills, how can you strengthen your soft skills? The soft skills are foundational skills. First of all, we need to understand that, that soft skills are the foundational skills. 2012 survey, US have shown that 50% have this degree in the humanities. That person should learn math, science, social, etc. If we say I'm happy, will not work. If you wake up and just say I'm a good person, I'm good son, daughter, it will be more effective. So you need to work on these qualities. In humanities, it works so. In soft skills, we can work like that. So interact. So you need to interact between them. So all these things would add to your personality, add to your soft skills, make you a greater person of tomorrow. And students would work better and get great results by working on their soft skills. That is communication, teamwork, framing, you know, having a great relationship, social emotional balance, mental health. All these factors will make you a great personality all together and make you to provide you a great result. So ending my session here. Thank you again, Teachers Tribe, for providing me the platform. So thank you all. Namaskar. Jai Hind.